Hey, welcome back everybody to episode 3 of my 7 Days to Die Let's Play series. And you guys see it is 2:30 PM already. I ran over here at 6:30 AM, straight over here. I actually still had some runners out there. Apparently the sun didn't really rise until 6:35 or something like that. So I had to deal with a few runners, but I got them out of the way. And I was doing really good here, and I have to say it's because of this weapon right here. That thing really is very handy. What is this? A spike club, right? Yeah, spike club. Because you're so much faster than if you use the bow. So what I do is I just run into a house. I now cleared this whole row here of houses, and this entire row, and some of this third row already. In just a few hours, I cleared, I think, 5 or 6 houses. Had the hiccups here a minute ago. So why is the spike club so good? It's because you can just run into a house. You don't need to wait and aim and stuff like that, which it's nice to be able to kill from range. And I just noticed I never picked this brass up here. But with the spike club, you know, you run up, one hit dead. Like over there in one of the houses, I had like 6 or 7 mobs come in behind me. And I just, you know, within 10 seconds, killed them all, looted them, and I was able to continue looting the houses. So I think that is really the thing to go, is if you're inside of these places here, I just run by zombies and let them come from behind when I'm looting inside of a house and then just kill them. Just don't waste any time, and that's what it is. So what is the plan? Because it's already late in the day, what I'm gonna do now is go through these Oh, by the way, there's a saying, when it rains, it pours. Why I was over here looting the houses as much as I can is I wanted a forge book. And then I found 2 forge books in one house. What are the odds, right? I mean, I love it. So that is the thing I really wanted before I start base building. So I also got the shotgun, pistols. I think we have pretty much, let's see here real quick, weapons. Does it show them in here? Yeah, we got pistol, sawed-off shotgun, SMG, hunting rifle. So we got everything but the sniper and the magnum. So that's really good. I've never gotten the Magnum before in my multiplayer, neither, where I'm on day 90 now. But I did have the sniper rifle, but I've only found parts for 1 sniper rifle. It seems to be very rare. Anyway, so we're doing awesome on everything. Let me show you also real quick. Over here, look at all these weapon parts. I want to get all this stuff over to the house today. And the same with this. I want to get everything over here. I got 1 blood drug kit, which is nice because you can use this to make blood bags, which you need to make first aid kits. So that's, you also just always just need 1, just like the beaker. Also took 2 refrigerators because that's where I want to store the food when we get going. And then over here, I got a bunch more gobbledygook, you know, lots of scrap metal, gun oils, ammo, and so on. So it's not too much, but I want to get everything that I have here back to the house. I keep pressing my recording shortcut, which is Alt and R. R for recording, and I never use that shortcut for anything else. That starts and stops my recording. But when I'm in a chest and want to start recording and I do that, then the entire inventory always comes to my inventory, which is a pain in the butt. But oh well, eventually I'm gonna learn. And I'm just now putting everything back here, somewhat sorted. Pistols up here and magnum parts and hunting rifle for now here. Shotgun stuff. You know, just trying to get a little. I can probably scrap a lot of this stuff, but I didn't want to waste any time looking through all of this right now. And so, check it. This is, you know, all weapons. Over here, I brought back. This is the axe I was using, but I found a flawless fire axe in there, which I want to use now to chop down a bunch of wood and other gobbledygook. Metals, we got okay amount. It's really not a lot, but that's okay. And I'm gonna fill these 3 up with water. We're doing good on seeds, which, you know, probably next episode I would like to set up. Tomorrow, day 4, not next episode. I want to set up a small farm to get the coffee and potatoes and so on going. Medical supplies. And, oh yeah, up here we got a little bit of food, which, ooh, I got to eat something. Let's eat a lamb ration. Oh man, I'm completely out of food again. But now that we don't need to go back to the village much, at least for a while, I should be able to hunt some animals here during the day, maybe. You know, if I comes across something, I'm gonna get it. All right, so like I said, it's I got about another hour of daytime, and I want to chop some wood up here and also collect a bunch of plant fiber if I can. So let's start right here with these. And dang it. Ouch. I want to bring that one seat. Don't break your leg. I'm such a rush. I want to get, you know, as much as I can before the night comes so we can do something during it. Where is it? It was here. Okay, seeds. There we go. I got a maple seed, and this is also maple seeds. So I can replant those ASAP. And they don't need any spacing, we found out on the multiplayer server I'm playing on. My buddy Sheridan, he planted, I think, did he say like 18 stacks of these seeds in one go? It's just an enormous wall of wood. It's crazy. Sorry that this is so loud, but like I said, I'm gonna get as much of this as I can real quick and replant it. Nothing here yet. Wonder why. If maybe they are gonna grow one bigger, but I'm not sure. I think I'm gonna run across over here. Nah, let me just deforest all this here real quick. And like I said, I'd like to get some plant fiber because I wanna start preparing some cobblestone frames. You need, I think, wood sticks and plant fiber for that. And wanna make sure that I don't break this axe. Because that's really nice. You see how fast you chop down trees. I mean, that is definitely nice to have. I think the only thing faster is gonna be a chainsaw, but I rather keep the gas for the auger for when I go mining and stuff. Eventually, I don't think we have an. We're missing one part. I know I have a small engine, but I'm not sure if I got the handlebars or the auger blade. One of them too, I think I got. So we still cannot make an auger. I know this is a lot of wood, probably, but you can go through. Ooh, only a stack and a half so far. All right, and of course I do have this one on here. All right, guys, this is very boring now. I'm just gonna collect plant fiber here, just so I have it, and then I'll see you guys down in the hole. When the sun is set, and we're gonna look at the weapons and cook up water. Oh yeah, I can't forget that. Let me do this real quick before I keep going with the. Might as well get this guy. Before I keep going with the plant fiber, I want to fill these 3 stacks of water so we can cook those up overnight also, just so I have them. It's always good to have a lot of water. And I have to replant these seeds. I can't forget that. Hello? Go fill it. All right, guys. Don't want to bore you. I'll be back in a minute. All right. I came in now. It's 6:30. You see, my axes are almost gone, but we got plenty of stuff. Got a stack and a little bit of plant fiber. I must have picked this one up by mistake. Let me just clear up my inventory a little bit. And doom, we got 3. So I think what I want to do is definitely make another campfire just so I have 2 of them. Because you can cook up more than 1 stack of stuff in a campfire. So for example, I can put all. Oh, you guys, by the way, saw I cooked up some talon last night. Actually, this morning, just before I took off, I put it in there so we can make candles or something. You guys see, I put 3 stacks of murky water in here, and this can be 15 minutes. All right, let's use. How much is this gonna be? Let's just use all of this stuff. Bam. and cook. I'm gonna need a few more to get that up. There we go. That should be enough. And that's nice. Don't need to worry about this anymore now. Cool. Let me craft this all up into logs. I'm not gonna worry about the spikes yet. Which requires you to use wood logs. Actually, I don't think I'm gonna need this much. You know what? Let's just stop right there. I think that I'm overthinking this. That's not too much, but I do have a lot of planks in here. So why don't we use up stuff first? Now, let's make some candles here first. Candle. So I can put some more light. I like candles better than torches, simply for the fact that it seems that I get better FPS with candles instead of torches. That's just, I believe that's true. I can't really say it is, but a lot of other people also that I play with. Ooh, level 13, nice. Which means that we should probably make... Ah, we'll look into this into a minute. But now what I can do is, first of all, just light this up a little bit going up. Yeah, I hate that these candles... I want to see them. I can't stand when you can't see it. Alright, there's one. Just so we got, you know, we can see something going up and down. I do believe that they cause heat. But... Oh my goodness. Place the candle. There we go. See, like this. At least you can see where you run. I like that a lot better. Don't want to go up too high. Can I place you somewhere? Oh, well. Let's go a little bit further. That's fine. So, let me talk about my plans here for the actual base. I think for now, I'm going to just keep our storage and stuff down here. But above this hole here, you know, I want to make the main fortification. It's just going to be a square, either 9 by 9 or 11 by 11, something like that. I want to keep this footprint as small as I can for up there. Because the smaller the footprint, the easier it will be to, you know, make it, fortify it. The less materials I need to fortify it, the less spikes I need, and so on. And, you know, for our first base, this is not going to be our main base. At least, it's going to be our base until at least day 17, most likely day 14. After that, I would like to, you know, have a new base somewhere else, but we'll see when we get to that. So down here, I don't really want to do more in this corner, because eventually up here, you know, underneath the tower, I want to start hollowing out and make, you know, side rooms. I would even like to try, I haven't tried that yet, so I don't know if it's possible, if we can make an underground farm. I think that would be very interesting to have your farms underground. All you gotta do is pick up dirt and place it again. Because that way, you know, you can farm and all that stuff during the day. And it is a zombie apocalypse, so I personally would stay underground as much as I can if this was real life. Now, let's see here. Okay, let's take a look at... What did I make the second fireplace for? Give me a second. I'm cooking water. Was there something else I wanted to cook up? No, I wanted to make a forge. That's what I wanted to make. Yes. My bad. Let's just make one, even though we might not need it just yet. And I need a short pipe. And I'm just gonna make one, because we're not gonna do as much forging just yet. Eventually, I want, you know, have 5 or 6 of these. Or at least one for every single mold, so you don't need to switch those around. Alright, let's take a few seconds to finish. And let's see here real quick. What type of pickaxe do I have? Alright, I just got this crappy faulty one, so I definitely want to make a new iron pickaxe. The shovel isn't too bad, a fine one. We don't have to dig as much dirt, it will work. And we're gonna need the nail gun later. I don't need 2 of these. So I can actually turn this into scrap. And there's my forge. put this away. And the forge, we are gonna put... Where are we gonna put you? Yeah, get right there, my friend. And I'm gonna put this torch into here, and... Actually, you know what? We can have this... Yeah, let's take this with us in case we start mining or something. And let me put a candle. Dang it. Put a candle right there and there. It's probably gonna be so much better for you guys right now with the recording. Should have put them down here first before I went up the tunnel. Okay, cool. So, oh no. I don't have any clay. Alright, we gotta get clay in the morning. I totally forgot about that. You need clay to make the molds. So we cannot smelt any iron right now, nothing. Okay, no problem. Let me get the plant fibers that we have out. And let's take a look at the frames. Don't think you can see this here until you make it. So for example, does it show you here? Yes, you see the hardness on the wood frame, it shows 4. And then you can reinforce that with wood twice, and then also with scrap metal to make it even tougher. And I think cobblestone has... Okay, don't count me on it, but I think it's in the 20s, maybe 23 or something like that. And then there is, of course, the rebar frame that you can make reinforced concrete, I think it's called, out of it, which I believe is the hardest. But I found that the cobblestone... It's really nice in the beginning, especially. It's very, very tough. To me, it's a lot easier to farm stone, to make gravel, and then to make cement, than it is to gather the scrap metal to reinforce your wood properly. So, why don't we make a bunch of these frames so we can lay this out in the morning? And I'm probably gonna have to make more sticks than that. So make me 300, that's gonna take a second. Alright, it's making the last few, and there we go. Alright, so now we can make... Where'd it go? Cobblestone frame. There it is. And that's what I like about this crafting system, you know, you just make one. And, of course, I'm gonna make more right now. We're gonna need at least... Let's see how much we can make altogether. 63, so that's gonna make me a stack. Perfect. And the nice thing is with this crafting system is, you know, as long as you have the mats on you, you can just, you know, build in and make them on the go so you don't have so many left over. So because we cannot make the pickaxe right now, I do think that I'm going to... let me just check here, just so I'm not getting something wrong. Iron pickaxe, it's going to cost 3 of these. And I do believe... The scrap metal plus the iron fragments, I'm gonna have enough to make at least those 3 ingots. It's probably gonna be a lot more. I don't know the exact... I can't put this in here, I think, until... Yeah, I have a mold in here, so I can't put this in there yet. So I cannot make this iron pickaxe, but I think we're gonna take this one and use it up first. Yeah, I'm not gonna ever gonna use this. Quality 69 is just terrible. But I think that for the rest of the night until it's morning and we can actually go and do something, I might just, you know, go around and chip out some of the stone because I'm gonna need a lot of it. And just to show you why we need it. We need clay before we can continue with the actual cobblestone, because we need the clay to make the iron ingot cast and then also the cement cast. But cement, you can take these regular stones, break them up into small stones, so you get 8 per stone. And let me just make one so it's easier to show. Bam! And out of these 8, I forgot the recipe, we can make gravel. One of these gravels, and then with that we can make cement. Wait a second, cobblestone rocks, we need the small stones and we need the cement, a concrete mix. Wait a second, what is this cement? Oh yes, of course, duh. It's with the mold in the furnace. You just take one gravel to, you can use a gravel or you can use, I believe, broken stone or stone. So never use stone. Always break the stone down into small stone and then make gravel out of it, because you're gonna get twice as much. Okay, enough of this. I'm gonna just go ahead and just take a little bit of stone out, just so I do something until 6:30 a.m. All right, it's almost time for us to go outside. I'm gonna drink a beer to get my hydration up a little bit, and it also gives you this buzz here. Two every 1 second. I don't know how long it lasts, but a grain alcohol lasts about 15 minutes real life time. And I want to use the beer first around the house here, because you cannot drink beer when your hydration is full, and it has gotten me killed in the past. And I'm trying to get away from dogs or something, and then I tried to drink beer but my hydration was full. So that sucked. And I'm gonna take these with me, and I'm gonna show you guys real quick why. These iron pipes, which we soon can make more ourselves, I'm gonna turn into strips. Actually, I'm just gonna turn half into strips. Oh god, everything takes forever with the crafting timers. Alright, and what you do with these is you can repair these metal items. So you see a fire axe is at 87 of 568. And I think I showed this earlier. If you put one, it's gonna give us 10. So this is gonna go up one. So this is just, I want to have this with me so I can keep repairing my items. But now, enough talking. Perfect timing, 6:42. We're gonna go upstairs and get some clay first. I want to get clay so I can make the molds to start making the cement. Anybody here? Nope. All right, then usually we can find clay. There's some right here. I think this is clay. Let's see. Is this clay? Yes, perfect. I just need a few of these pieces. I'm just gonna get these few here. And that is all we're gonna need for right now. I know where there's more if I need more. But the clay turns into, let me get out of here. The clay turns into clay balls at, I think, 1 to 5 or something like that. And when I get these molds going, the first thing we're going to do is start cooking the iron. So I can make a pickaxe. And then I was thinking of possibly spending the next night. I'm just going to make all, well, it makes you 9, 18. Alright, that's enough for now. So I don't need to wait. And clay balls like this makes you the iron ingot mold. And what was the other one I was gonna make? The cement mold. Is that with, I have to check real quick, I forgot what that is made with. Cement mold, ah, okay, like this. Now, why did I close it? Okay, and we're gonna make a lot of other molds eventually. So now we got this one, and I can start cooking the iron, which I really want to get to. So I made this one over here for this stuff. We can put that in there, and this, and that. Now let's get, where are my couches? They're right. Let's use these guys right here. They burn a long time. And let's start with these fragments here first. Put the mold in here, and you see it shows you capacity 3.0. That's how much you need. And one of these gives us, so 10 of these is gonna be enough to make 2 ingots. What? If one gives me 0.3. Oh, yeah, of course. So that is one. I don't wanna waste any more. And that's gonna cook for 24 seconds. So let's just put, I want to save as much materials as I can. So this is just going to make us one iron ingot. And then I want to check the scrap here, how much that makes us. To compare it. It should be done 6 seconds. We can wait for that. And then I'm going to start this cooking. And I don't need to worry about the pick just yet. So there's one. How much does one scrap give us? 0.5. So 6 scrap is going to make, well, there we go. Let's just cook this up. So that's gonna take 4 minutes. Perfect. Awesome. We're gonna have 11 iron ingots, which is nice. We can use that to repair tools and, of course, make tools. Where is my couch? Just there they are. Okay, so this is going. And now, yeah, we got the clay. We're gonna go mining here, probably at night. I think that's the best. I don't think that I'm gonna have problems with mobs destroying these frames here, even if I don't make cobble out of it. So we can lay it out right now and figure out if we like it. Now let me check here. Don't think I need to. Let's see. I'm worried about, because this is very thin here, that this might collapse or something. So let's just see. I'm probably gonna close this hole from the bottom. So let's just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that leaves inside 5 by 5. I like this. Let's see how far we can get. This is gonna be in the air, but I can fill this in later. You know, I wanna, like I think I explained this early, I wanna keep the footprint as small as possible. So that is 5, 6, 7. Oh no. Really? Let's just get some dirt real quick. I don't want to make any unnecessary holes around the base if I can help it. This iron shovel is so nice. Of course we're losing stamina, so I'm gonna drink another beer real quick so I can keep the stamina. The beer is not as good. The grain alcohol is just, to me, a lot of people swear by coffee, but coffee lasts 180 seconds, and if you have a good corn production, well, it's really easy to make grain alcohol, I think. Now, all this is filling in behind me, right? Yes. Okay, now this is a little dangerous because it's hard for me to get out, but that is fine. Let's close in some of this stuff here, just so I have some more stability here. And probably here, here. All right, now let's see how we're doing over this way. So that is 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that would be 8 and 9 to cover the hole. So I'm probably gonna make this a 9 by... Does it matter if it's a 7 by 9? Who cares? It doesn't need to be square, right? Let's just go like this. That is fine. Could be anything. So right there, can I fill this in? Yes, I can. It's gonna be hard to get out here, but I'm just gonna use wooden frames for that. Come on, place it there. Okay, and now I guess, should I come over here or one? Let's just go one further, it don't matter. So like this. And 1, 2, so this is our entrance for now, so I can still get down. Later on there won't be any entrance on the bottom layer. It's gonna be via ramp. I think it's fine that this is not, you know, square. Who cares? 2, 4, 6, so this is a 9 by 7, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. And let's just lay these out so I get kind of an idea how many more of these I need to make. And what time is it? 8 a.m. This is perfect. We're gonna be able to make the pick, then go over into the other mining hole, because you guys remember there was this big drop off down into the water. So if I need to break stone, I might as well do it over there, trying to make a pathway down towards that water so we can take a look on the inside of this cave. So this is too tall. Obviously I'm gonna need to make this, let's just go like that, 3 tall. I think this structure right here is gonna be 5 tall. There's gonna be spikes on the floor here, and then 1, 2, 3, and on the 4th one, so the 5th height is gonna be the overhang, because you gotta have an overhang. So the spider zombies, the screamers, cannot climb into your base. So I'm gonna have to make this one taller. Jump. All right, and I got one, two more. So I gotta get a lot more plant fiber, but let's make the pickaxe first so we got this all out of the way. And now I'm gonna start running into a problem. I can keep this out for now, I think. Yeah. And let's put, I'll put one right there. I cannot jump up this. How am I gonna do that? One, two, ah, not there. Let's put it right here. I can't jump up there. All right, there, there, jump. I just want something, yeah, like this, good. All right, I only have two more frames, so let's go ahead and go down here and make our pickaxe. Make more frames. Because you can never have enough of these for when you go into a mining shaft to make ladders and, you know, stuff like that. I say ladders, to make steps, because I don't like ladders in this game very much. They cause way too many broken legs. So, we got 11 of these, which is awesome. And now, hopefully, I'm gonna be lucky and get a good item level quality pickaxe. Cross your fingers. Would be nice to get. What's after poor? Good. I don't know if I can get a good yet. Does this take it out? I'm 13, so I can be 180. No, I can only get a poor one. There's nothing else possible, but at least it's going to be full. And bam, there it is. What do we get? 105. All right, it's better than the other one that we had. And I don't need anything else. I do have the frames. I am gonna bring these guys here just so I can make a little more light if it's needed. We're doing good at time. I'm gonna go mining for like 2-3 hours in game now, just to get as much stone as I can so we can get the cement started. And it was somewhere this way. It's over here. It's not too far to get there. And I also said it would be nice if we could get some animals today. Just gonna do it. If I find any animals, I just kill them. There's lots more clay over there. Where are you, hole? I see you right there. All right. This is what I like the torch for, by the way, because you know, let's say you mine at night, and it gets really dark, and you switch to the pick. Well, your light's gonna be out. And with the torch, you know, you can just place it on the wall and done. I guess you could do the same with candles. But, I don't know. In the mining shaft, I think torches are better. They just make more sense than candles, right? Mushrooms. I don't even know what they're for, by the way, mushrooms. I'm not going to worry about any of the stalactites here. So now this is where we want to get down to. Because I'd like to get to this ledge right there. So let's see here real quick. Can I place you there and there? Good. So now, oh look, I don't even need to dig. I can just make a ladder down like this. If I remove you, am I gonna fall? Good. No. Alright. See, this is, I like these so much better than ladders. I love these wooden frames. Okay, let's put one here, one there, and another one here. Cool, we're down here. That was easier than I expected. There's nothing. I can't see if there's anything in the ceiling. There's often stuff in the ceiling. Oh, gravel marks ore. When there's gravel, that's where I always dig. And it's perfect because gravel is going to give us cement. Put it back right there. So I got a little light. And if you break gravel on the bottom, okay, if I break this bottom one, well, nothing's going to happen here because there's nothing above it. Oh my god, this pick is so terrible. Oh, wait. Gravel is shovel, I think, right? Yes, my bad. It wasn't the pick's fault. It was my fault. See, now, if I break this one down here, this top one, I can just show you once. You see how the top one fell down? So I wasted it. So I don't want to do that. So what I'm going to do is go up here and dig the gravel down from the top. Somewhere. There we go. So that's the first gravel. So I don't lose anything because, well, I want to keep this gravel, right? And then we'll see what's behind it. Alright, the first gravel over there didn't reveal anything. It's over there. I'll show you in a second. So I started... I can dig one lower before the water comes in. Right? Right? No. No, 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 no. We don't want water in here. No, stop it, stop it. Every water block in this game is a water source block. Just so you guys know. So if you get water in here, it's going to spread. And then it's going to fill this entire thing with water. And then it's a pain in the butt to get rid of. Can I please place you? If I place you right here and I break this, it's going to go away. So I got to break this first. And place it there. And this looks like we found potassium nitrate, which is really not what I wanted to find at first, but you know, iron or coal would have been nicer. Now stop spreading. Alright, so this looks like, is this stone? Let's see. No, this is also potassium nitrate. And quick, no, switch. Alright, good. Alright, so I got this blocked off and I can dig more gravel here at night. But for now, I think we have enough. How am I going to get back up here? Like this. Like that. And I'm out of frames, but I waited. Okay. This right here was, right? Yeah. Right here was where all the gravel was. And there's nothing. Nothing behind it. But I got 3.5 stacks of gravel now. So I want to go back to the house and start cooking this. And next night, I'm definitely going to be down here. I think the entire night with, well, a little bit of food and whatever I can get. Because I'm going to need to, you know, mine a lot of stone. And it really sucks because this pickaxe is terrible. So it's going to be very painful. But I'm going to do this the entire next night. Because we're going to need a lot of... stone to make small stones. Actually, let me see here real quick. I don't know if it might be better if I do... This is stone. Okay, no, I need this or destroyed stone. I was kind of, I don't know what I was thinking. I thought that cobblestone rocks is maybe made with small stones, but no. Because those would have been easier to just run around and farm, you know, like this. But no. So... I think right now, until, or for the rest of the day, I want to A, start the cement, and B, maybe look for something to eat. Maybe try to find an animal in the area and kill it so we got, you know, we can maybe make some roasted meat or charred pork or something like that. Because I am running low on food, and when I am down to... I ate the eggs earlier to get my food up to where it is now. The boiled eggs that we had left. And all we have left is these three cans here. Which is, well, nothing I can do. Where did I put the... Right there. So, put the gravel. We're going to start with one stack here. I don't need any of this. Leave the potassium nitrate here and the dirt. And the mushroom. Goes in here. Alright. And you know what? I think I'm gonna plant this potato, these, and I'm gonna take the coffee with me. I think that I found a hole, didn't I? No, we gotta make a hole also, right? I don't have a hole. Nope. Okay. So, let's switch these molds out. And 256, 34 minutes. Perfect. So, let me get the couches. This up to 35 minutes. It's gonna make a lot of cement, but we'll need it. We'll need it, so it's okay. And that's just one stack, so that's good. So now all I really need is, I got plenty of wood. I'm gonna need plant fibers and stone. So that's gonna be really tough. But hoe, let's make a iron garden hoe. You'll always just need to make one of them. It doesn't matter what the quality is, I think, of them either. Right click is right click, if I'm not mistaken. So for now, I am gonna plant this outside. Let's make a potato seed or four more potato seeds and plant all this real quick so you guys see that. Put this in here. I'm gonna keep those on me in case I need to repair stuff. Actually, let me just show you guys in case I need that at night. You turn an iron ingot into forged iron.
Ooh.
Actually, how much leather do I have? I think we can make ourselves a crossbow. No, I'm not making this yet because I want to use up the arrows first. So scrap that. We'll make that next time probably. Yes. So these four forged iron turn into 12 pipes, which then turn into 60 strips. It's pretty good ratio, I think. It's not too bad. But you guys see, I'm used 50 or something just to repair the shovel earlier. And I'm sure I'm gonna need a ton of this for the pickaxe. And that's why I'm keeping those on here. Finding iron isn't too hard. And let's eat the salmon. It's very little nutritional value. Yeah, look at this. Barely anything. All right, cement is cooking. And yeah, let's make the garden real quick. And I think that will be it for today because then all I'm gonna do is get plant fiber. I'm gonna have to change this here up eventually. It's gonna be a ladder. Where are we gonna put the garden? I don't wanna have it too close to the house, but not too far away. I think over here is a really good spot. Let's level this out. Let's get rid of this grass real quick. It's just scared the hell out of me. But they did not see me. And I'm not gonna tell them I'm here. That's a wandering day horde. They spawn somewhere over there and then they just go somewhere. I don't know what their plan is. But they have not seen me or heard me break this grass. And I'm okay with that because I don't have any time to waste. And there's the slow pokes after the rest of them. So I think I made a nice little empty area over here. And of course, I also wanted the plant fiber, so it was okay to get this done. Doesn't bother me. It's 12 o'clock. We're not doing too bad. I wonder if I should kill these three. Just so maybe I get something to eat or something. What? The fatty didn't hear me? Okay, I'll take that. That lets me repair my pick. Ooh, what did we get? Hunting knife book, I think I already know that one. Yes. Too bad. All right. And like I said, later on, I would like to try to get my farm underground. I don't want to keep it up here. Where is. I don't have any planks on me. What? I mean, frames. How many can I get? 27. Make them. They're crazy. Can I level this out here? Wait a second. Why is this all lower? Huh? How do I get this to come up? I can't. All right, not gonna worry. Gonna put the farm right there. Let's just get this going. I don't have any time to waste. So with the hole, you just right click one time and you see how it makes this you need to go diagonal, by the way. It makes this farmland. And you cannot have one directly next to it. So you need to go one block further so you can make these diagonal lines. I heard you. You sneaky little thing. And of course, you need to die on my frickin' farmland. So now I need to wait for this to turn into a breakable body. All right, but can I hold you right there? Oh, it breaks it. Sweet. What? Yeah, this hoeing is—it's very weird in this game. That's the one thing that I have not really. Look at this. What does it make it all crooked and stuff? What? Well, maybe I'm. You gotta be kidding me, right? Can you just make this in a straight line? Driving me bonkers. All right, so that should be enough right now. Let's see. We got one blueberry seed. Sure, we'll plant you over here. And wait for the bounding box to come when you don't know how to plant yet. Because you can misplant this, and then it plants it above the ground, and then it falls down, and you lose the seed, and it's a pain in the butt. Potatoes are really important. I don't think we've found any corn yet. I don't think I remember seeing any corn, which we need to make vegetable stews and venison stew and grain alcohol. And don't die on my farmland. Okay, guys, you get the idea. I'm gonna plant the rest of the stuff here, the potatoes, the coffee beans, and then, like I said, I'm gonna set out and see if I can get lucky and find... Man, this wandering horde is not stopping. Only she has seen me. Oh, look at that. Sniped. And then when the night comes, I want to be in this other hole over there. Hopefully I have some food cooking up by then. And I want to be in the other hole so I can mine some stone. I need to mine stone. There's no way around it to get everything I need for making that cobblestone mix. And I'm going to need this here in a minute. Another one. Oh, I missed her. Maybe you got some medication for me? Aw, oh, fatty got me. That was a headshot. And another one. And this is gonna kill him. Nice. There's another one coming. Alright, I'm sorry that I'm dragging this out as long longer than it needs to be. But I'd like to show more, but it's gonna have to wait until next episode. Maybe I'll tune in at night when I... am I down there mining? Ow, 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 ow. What are you doing? What are you doing, mister? No. Oh. Whew. Not paying attention. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed the episode. And hopefully next episode we can finish our structure over here to make it safe at night. So we can actually make noise and stuff downstairs. And not worry about mobs coming in. And I'll talk to you guys then. Take care. Stay safe. And bye-bye.